Hallelujah. Oh, I lift you up, Lord. Oh, I make you bigger than I. I decrease so that you may increase. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Lord. I love you. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you. I love you, Lord. Oh, I love you. Oh, you're worthy. Worthy is the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I worship you, Lord. Oh, I lift up mine eyes unto the hills. From which cometh my help. All of my help comes from the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, I love you, Lord. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Lord. Oh, I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm nothing without you, God. Oh, I'm nothing without you, Lord. Oh, I'm nothing without you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, I worship you every day, every minute, every hour, every second. Oh, I love you, Lord. In all that I do, I worship you, Lord.
Jesus. Listeners, I just thank God because He is awesome. And I thank God for the Word of God. And right now I'm going to give you the book, which is Romans, the second chapter. And we're going to be preaching and teaching out of Romans, not just one verse, but many verses out of Romans. And I thank God for that. And my thought today will be the judgment of God. The judgment of God. Second chapter of Romans. Therefore thou art inexcusable, O man, O woman, O boy, O girl. Amen. Whosoever thou art that judges, for within thou judges another, thou condemnest thyself. Though that thou that judges does the same thing. But we are sure that the judgment of God is according to truth against them which committed such things. And thinkest thou this, O man, that judges them which do such things. And doest say that thy shall escape the judgment. Again, I will tell you, we're going into this chapter. We have more verses. I will tell you the subject is the judgment of God. Repeat after me, say the judgment.
The judgment
of God.
Of God.
Thank you. The reality of sin, an introductive for preaching. Sometimes I know folks wonder why you preach on sin, but then if you didn't, wasn't no sinner, you wouldn't need to preach. If you was not, if sin wasn't there, you wouldn't need a preacher. If sin wasn't in us, Jesus wouldn't have needed to come to this earth, but he came to destroy the works of the devil. He came because we are sinners. And you that are in the house of God, you are a sinner saved by grace. Because everybody that's born of a woman is a sinner. Because the Bible tells us that you're born in sin and you're shaped in iniquity. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
When Paul's letter was read to the Roman church, because these are letters from our apostle Paul, but when it was read in the Roman church, no doubt many are like we are today. When he read this chapter about sin, we nod our head. That's what they did. We nod our head when we talk about sin. We bow our head to the word that comes forth. But you know what you need to do? Stop bowing your head. We know there's sin everywhere. We know there's sin in the world and in the church house. And in the church house, it shouldn't be. It shouldn't be, because who's in the church house? The church. Amen. It said they nodded their heads sometimes, you know, as he condemns. You know, when folks, when you send a take a word come forth that hits somebody else, then you got first know that. But if you knew they was in sin, why did you go to them since you so holy? If you knew they was doing wrong, why did you go to them? Amen. And then you wouldn't have to bow your head and say, yes, that's what they're doing. Yes, they're doing this. Yes, they're doing that. Hallelujah. So, we want to stop and think. I say that a lot, don't we?
Amen.
We want to stop and think before we do the nod and the speaking. Praise God. And so we nod our head when we speak on homosexuality practices. But you know God is able to save that person.
Yes.
God is able to save to the uttermost.
Yes.
I don't care who you are or what you are. If you call on the name of the Lord, he said, you shall be saved. Amen?
Amen.
And we as a church need to believe every word. Amen. We say that cometh out of the mouth of God. Why you say it coming out? Because it's inspired. It's an inspired word of God that he gave to man to write about. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, Jesus. And then we look at violent people. So people are violent in this world today. Don't care what they say about you. Don't care what they say to you. But they are violent. And all of this violence. When we speak of these things, folks get to nod their head and nod. Well, if you know that they are violent, why don't you say something? Why don't you talk to them? Why don't you open your mouth and say, that shouldn't be. You shouldn't be like that. And only God. See, you can't say, I'm going to help you because you can't.
Amen.
Only God can change that situation. Can't nobody change it but God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good, people.
Yeah.
Amen. You know what? When we look at this scripture, we'll be surprised at what Paul is saying. You, as a person that has read this and read the first chapter, we know up above is a lot of things that God say is an abomination. God don't like it, and you shouldn't like it. You should shun it. Is that right? Well, what a surprise his listeners got. Amen. They must have felt when he turned on them. Because see, he didn't just stay on the ones that was bad.
Right.
But he turned on the ones that was also good, because you need to stop and think. You ain't always been where you are today.
Amen.
Nobody.
Amen.
Nobody.
No.
Is perfect.
Amen.
We all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Amen.
So you know, I said we're going to be talking to the sinners. Amen.
Amen.
For the next few weeks. Because God's judgment is coming.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you cannot say, if you heard it on radio or TV, you cannot say, I didn't know that. But God is a just,
yes, he is.
God. Because you find out when you're judging them and you stop to think, you yourself is just as bad.
All right. Amen.
Why are you judging somebody else? You need to stop and look at your own self.
Yeah.
You know, if we would take the time to search our own heart, search out what we're doing, search out what we're saying, search out where we're going, we will find out that we just as bad as them. We are a person that have confessed. We said with our mouth and believe in our heart, but we're still doing what we should not do. So quit trying to judge somebody else. Judge yourself. Judge yourself. Somebody say glory. You are just as bad as that next person. If we stop and look at ourselves, I tell you a lot of times, look at yourself in the mirror, look at yourself.
Yes, right.
Talk to yourself in the mirror.
Amen.
Talk to yourself.
Yes, Lord.
Tell God about it in the mirror.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Sure.
It's a search that we must do. I can't search you. I can tell you what thus said the Lord.
Yeah.
It is something that we have to do for ourselves.
Yeah.
You got to do it for yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Paul was empathetically stressed. Why was he stressed? That nobody is good enough to save him or herself. When did you get good enough to save yourself? He said he died for you. Best look to the cross. Look to the cross, what he did for you. Because we can't save ourselves. Ain't no way. Praise God. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. If we wanted to avoid punishment, if we want to get out of being punished, what we got to do is shut. I'm going to tell you. You got to live for Christ. Let's say that again. You got to live for Christ. All of us, not one of us, not two of us, all of us. I don't care whether you are a murderer, a molester, or whatever. We have been earnest, hardworking, and solid citizen must depend totally on God, no matter what you have done. No matter if you've killed somebody. If you still got some breath in your body, you need to repent.
Yeah. Yeah.
You need to ask forgiveness from God. And God will. See, God ain't got no respect for a person.
Amen.
Open your mouth and God will forgive you.
Yeah.
But stay in forgiveness. Walk in forgiveness.
Yeah.
Don't go back into that same old mess again.
Amen.
Don't tell me that, well, I'm like that because I've always been like that. Why? If you accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, then tell me, why are you still the same or what? Why haven't you changed? Because when you accept our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, as your Savior, you are a changed person. There ain't nobody that was sincere stay the same. There's a lot of issues that you need to get rid of, but you don't stay the same. The church have issues, and they need to get rid of them. You need to cast them away from you. Praise God. You can't be good, just good, and go to heaven. You cannot be just good and come in the house and think you've got everything you need. Good don't go. Praise God. Hallelujah. You got to be real from your head to your toes. Thank God for weave. Thank God for that. But it's yours. Amen. That's your hair. You got on that weave, that's your hair. That's what, this is my hair. I bought it. It's my hair. Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Ain't God good, y'all? And I know that we all want to avoid punishment. We don't want to be punished, right? I want to be a total Christian, serving a total God. Amen. That's what I want to be. Paul is not discussing with us some folks sin. When we look at these scriptures, he's not discussing that some have sinned, but all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Amen. Any sin is enough to cause us, I don't care how small you say it is, I don't care. Do you know sin is sin?
Yes.
It doesn't matter if you murder somebody or you're a homosexual or either you just lie. That's sin. Sin is sin. You can't have it down the middle and say, my sin ain't that much. But there you ought to know their sin. Your sin is just as bad and as much as the person on the left side. Because you say, I'm okay over here on the right side. I didn't do much. You don't have to do much. Sin is sin. A three-letter word. It's sin. Anybody here?
Amen.
Somebody say thank you.
Thank you.
I thank the Lord that we've all been saved by grace. But there's no way apart from Christ that me, you, or anybody else can make it in. Hallelujah, somebody. God seeks to make us aware of our greatest problem. You know, a lot of times you hear that little voice and you don't pay it no attention. He's speaking to you. You know, we said on Friday night, we need to stop and meditate. Sometimes you talk so much, you can't hear God. And we don't need to run our mouth all the time. We need to sit back and meditate and let God speak to you. Because God might want to speak to you about something that maybe you think you done forgot, or you done forgot, but when he bring it back to you, you remember. Because that's the kind of God he is. He'll bring you back what you need to know. He will do that. Amen. I tell you one thing. We are aware of our greatest problem through disease. That's a problem within itself. Poverty is a great big problem. Ain't nobody that belong to God got no business living in poverty. I say it again, nobody that is in God should live in poverty. Well, you say that because God said all the silver and the gold belong to him. He said even cows on 1,000 hills belong to him. If you want sheep, lamb meat, that's his too. Everything that God has, you can have it. Are you hearing me? Praise God. So I would say to you, the effect of sin, socially and spiritually, hallelujah. I want you to get this in your spirit. I want you to hear what I'm saying. Keep your ears on. Keep your ears wide so that what you hear in the natural will continue in the spirit, because you got to hear first. You got to hear first. Amen?
Amen.
The coming judgment in view on Romans 2 and 5 and 6. It tells us this. But after thy hardness and impenitent heart, treasure up unto thyself wrath against the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God, who will render to every man. Somebody say every man.
Every man.
According to his deeds.
Amen.
You know, we said on Friday night, you're going to get paid. You go to your job, you work, you get paid. If just suppose you go and work eight hours or 40 hours a week and they don't give you no paycheck. That'd be terrible, wouldn't it? You done did all that work and worked all them long hours and not getting paid. But here, you are going to get paid for sin.
Yes.
Sin is sin, no matter how you look at it. And we need to look at it in a way. Praise God that it will cause me and you, all of us, to search ourselves.
Yes.
I do that a lot. You know, I say that a lot. Search yourself. You need to learn to search your own self and judge what you're doing.
Yeah.
Then won't nobody else have to do that.
All right.
Won't nobody else have to judge you. All right?
Amen.
You can read Revelation 20 because that is a good end time chapter. The judgment of God according to the truth. In verse 2. Hallelujah, somebody. According to the truth. And when we look back, I go back to 20 in a minute, but we're going back to our lesson, Roman. Hallelujah. Yeah. And what did it say? It said, but we are sure. Now he said, we. Paul didn't say, I am sure, or you are sure. But he's talking to the congregation. Is that right? He said, but we are sure that the judgment of God is according to truth. Huh? Against them which commit such things. There is a lot of things before Paul got here in this second chapter that God didn't like. First chapter. He didn't like that. We're not going into that because in the 22nd verse, it would tell you some of those things that God did not like. All right? Somebody say glory.
Glory, glory.
Hallelujah. When judging loved ones, now we need to stop. I want you to just think about that. Because you got loved ones that know that they ain't doing right. Amen. But when judging loved ones, we are often partial.
All right.
That's your family. You don't want to tell them like it is. You don't want to come up in their face like you would a stranger. You need to tell them the truth just like you would somebody else. Hallelujah. Don't be partial in your judging. Don't be partial in your witnessing. Hallelujah. I don't want you to be partial. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Sometimes I'm not focused, or my eyes are not focused. Hallelujah. We allow our heart to move on what we know. But you know, my brother, my sister, my mother, my father's in sin. You know that my children is in sin. I want to ask you a question. Why don't you tell them that sin speaks? I'm going to say that. The scripture's not in there that says sin stinks in God's nostril, but it stink. How do you smell? Through your nostril. You can walk into a place and it's sinful in there. You can smell it. Sin stinks. Don't smell good at all. Are you hearing me? I am not finna rush. I'm just going slow. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody say thank you. We don't want to allow our heart to rule over what we know. In your heart, you know it. But in your heart, you love this person. And you don't want to tell them like it is. We sometimes bend the truth. But we need to tell them the whole truth. Somebody say the whole. We need to tell them the whole truth because Jesus said he was the truth. Not only is Jesus the truth, but he was the life. He's everything that we need. Who in here needs something else from somebody else? What you need comes from above that speaks into somebody on this earth, and they will bless you. Why is that? Because God spoke to their heart. I say God spoke to their heart. It's not about I went to such and such a person. And honey, they did me good. Why did they do you good? It was all because of God. You got nothing except God give it to you. And we need to be thankful for that. We need to be thankful for the health and the strength that he's given us every day to get up and walk. Most days you don't feel well, some of you. But God enabled you to open your eyes. You didn't lay as stiff as a board. It was God that woke you up. It was God that gave you to get up and go. It was God that moved them legs of yours so that you could get up and go. Come on here. And because God has done all of that for all of us, and then we turn our back on him, judgment day is coming. Can I say that again? Judgment day is coming. Are you hearing me? When we're being the truth, we don't need to ever do that. Because of who is involved. Amen. Because if that's my mama, I can't go to my mama like that. Yes, you can. Yes, you can if your mama a sinner, but you go to your mother with respect. Regardless whether you say and she a sinner or not. But you go to them with respect. When you witness for God, you witness with respect. You ain't got to go in accusing them. They already know who they are. They already know what they're doing. They already know that it's wrong. Amen? And so the one thing about it, you go to their respect. I'm not respecting your sin, but I am a person that has respect for others. You go in and you let them know. It's up to them to receive it. They can receive it if they want to. If they don't, they can leave it alone. Because you cannot make nobody be saved. All you can do is tell them and let them know And that's the cause of love. If I don't love the sinner, you got to love the sinner. I love the sinner. Jesus loved the sinner. And God sure enough loved the sinner. Because he gave Jesus to die for their sin. He loved the sinner. Hallelujah. Ephesians 5 and 21. No man ever yet hate or hated his own flesh. I don't think nobody in you hate your flesh. Sometimes we might not look the best, and we sort of not like what we look like when we look in the mirror. So when you look in the mirror and you look at yourself and you see something that you don't like, it's up to you to change it. It ain't up to nobody else to change you but you. We have to do that. But first you have to see it.
All right.
First you have to see what you don't like. Praise God. Come on.
Amen.
You know God see what he don't like. He does. And anybody that know this word or some parts of it or some of it, know what God hates. Know what God loves. Amen? Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Isn't God good, y'all? The judgment of God is according to accumulated wrath in verse 5. And we read that. We're going to read it again. I want y'all to know. But they, but after thy hardness and impenting heart. In other words, impenting, you didn't repent. After God sees all of this because he sees everything. Somebody say everything.
Everything.
Treasured up unto thyself wrath against the day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God. Isn't it all right?
Amen.
Somebody say thank you.
Thank you.
You store up treasures here on this earth because you can't take them with you. Most of us got so much of stuff that we don't know what to do with it. We need to give it away, get rid of it. Stuff. Praise God. Is God all right? I know he is. He is awesome. The privilege of laying up treasures in heaven. The frightening thought of training, of treasuring up wrath. Read that verse again. When you put a check mark by it so you can read that verse again, verse 5. So you read that verse again, talking about wrath. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. By despising the riches of God's goodness. Because God's goodness is rich. Everything God gives us, it is rich. Amen. It's going to be rich. The judgment is going to be rich for y'all that stand before him and be judged. And he's going to say, I never knew you. Because you're going to start talking about what you did. I prophesied in your name, Jesus. I worked in your name. I cleaned the church floor. I washed the windows. I did all that. What about me? Who did you tell about me? Who did you show me to? Doing all of that, who did you show me to? Glory to God. By cleaning this floor, sweeping the floors. Amen. You didn't witness to nobody. Did you talk to somebody about the Lord? See, I'm not telling you to witness to them and make them come in here. I'm saying you need to be a witness unto the sinner. Now, I'm not soliciting for no members. I am saying to you that no God Talk to that sinner man. Talk to that sinner woman. Let them know that Jesus is the real thing or the real deal. They got so many other things that they call real, but Jesus is the real deal. There's nobody like him. And can't nobody be on this earth today. A bit on this earth and gone. Can do you like Jesus. I don't care if you can wake up in the midnight hour, he's there. If you call a friend at midnight, he won't be or she won't be there for you. I'm in the bed. I'm tired. My children in the bed too. I'm not going to disturb them to do this for you and do that for you. No, but Jesus will never say that. When you call upon him, he will answer. With a sincere prayer, he will answer. I'm thanking God for his answer. Because he has answered me. As I wake up sometime coughing, and I pray and I ask him, Lord, allow me to sleep just a little bit more. Praise God. And then when I know anything, it's day. God allowed me to sleep a little bit more. And I didn't wake up with coughing. God is a prayer answering God. He's a God that do what? Loves you. And will answer your sincere prayer. Somebody say thank you.
Thank you.
You know, they're talking about that riches of God and how you get that by rejecting. You by rejecting the plea of God to come to repentance. You know, John the Baptist pleaded with the people to repent.
Yeah.
They all the time repent. 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 What is bad about repenting?
Amen.
That's a good thing.
Amen.
I ain't anybody here.
Amen.
If you repented, you ought to know.
Amen.
That is a what? Good thing.
Amen.
And the only way you're going to make it to him is to be that you have repented of your sin. And God is sorry for doing it. Ain't nobody sorry about nothing. They just say, Lord, forgive me for my sin and go on out and sin again. You cannot continue over and over and over again sinning and expect to stand before God and he call you good and faithful servant. Y'all hear me? Thank you, Jesus. God is awesome today. Every day of my life, he has been an awesome God. He has brought me, kept me. So why would I go and do anything different? Why would I sin on the man that has kept me all these 76 years? Kept me. And you know what? Now, I'm not saying that my mind was on him all the time. Because there was a period in my life where I didn't want to know God. I didn't know God and didn't want nobody to tell me about God. See, I want you to know, I'm not sitting here talking to you today because I accepted God. I am here talking to you today because I accepted God.
Yeah.
But I went through the devil's territory before I accepted him. All right.
Amen.
Old taste and see.
Yeah.
That the Lord, he is good. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
Ain't nobody in here didn't flip their legs and their dress and their splits and their low cuts and their strings. You was out there.
Yeah.
I was out there. We've been in the world, so you know what the world is all about. So why you want to dip and dab? Why you want to be straddle the fence? Why you want to be on this side on Sunday, on that side the rest of the week?
That's right.
Anybody here?
Amen.
You either going to have one or you're going to love one and hate the other. You ain't going to love both of them.
Amen.
You got to love God. God wants you to love him.
Yeah.
God wants you when you stand before him that he can tell you well done. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody here?
Amen.
Can we say thank you again?
Thank you.
Now, with constant rejection, because you know there's folks that constantly reject God. Mm-hmm. And they'll tell you, I don't want to hear that. Mm-hmm. I don't want to hear that, but you out there that are hearing me and listening to me, don't reject him. Come to him. And he will save you.
Yeah.
Come to him and repent of your sin. Be sorry for the things that you've done. Amen. Because every last one of us going to have to die. We are going to leave this earth. Amen. But it's up to you where you spend eternity. Anybody here? In verse 6, the judge must go. The judgment of God is according to works. The judgment of God is according to works. So we done work, but we have not yet told God. Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. I'm not going to go there, but you can read that for yourself. Not salvation by works. You cannot have salvation by how much you work, how much you clean, how much you do this, and how much you... Salvation comes through the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And it comes not by works, but by repenting. But by repenting of your sins. The many sins that we have done, but then all you got to do, ask God to forgive you for your sin. For your sin, S-I-N, sin, you sin, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Forgive me, God, for the things that I've done in my body. Because you said in your word that my body belonged to you, and I have sinned. Forgive me for that. We need to learn how to ask forgiveness for a lot of things. Because
yeah.
We all need forgiveness. Is he? Is you here?
Yeah.
God is just.
Mm-hmm.
Right up until your most desire, God is just. He said in his word, I will give you the desires of your heart. But it's got to be conditional. Do your ways please him? Do you please God? Huh? Revelation 20 again. And you're going to read the whole Revelation 20. According to the works. Luke 10 and 13. Tolerates. We don't need to tolerate doing this, doing that, and the other. Anybody here? We really need to know. 10th chapter, the 13th verse. Even the very dust. Wrong verse. Whoa. Now see, I want y'all to know that God is putting out, Paul is putting out some woes here.
Whoa.
Said, woe unto thee, Chorazin. Woe unto thee, Bethesda. For if the mighty works, listen to the works, had been done in Tyre and Sodom, which have been done in you, they had a great while ago repented, sitting in sackcloth and ashes. God didn't command you to sit in sackcloth and ashes, but he did command you to open up your mouth. And ask forgiveness for your sin.
Yes.
And the things that you are doing or have done, even after you came to Jesus, there is things that you have said and have done that you need to repent of.
Amen.
You need to be delivered of certain things that you know that you need to be delivered from, because we want you to know that once you get saved, I didn't say you was delivered. And once you get saved, everything ain't all right. You need to get rid of some of them isms, some of them issues that you say you've been like that all your life. You need to get rid of those because they are hindering you from seeing Jesus' face in peace. And I hope that everybody wants to see his, everybody gonna see him. But is everybody gonna see it in peace? Praise God. So, when we look at that 10 and 13, it tells us, for if the mighty works had been done in Tyre and Sidon, which have been done in you, they had a great while. Also, they would have repented, also repented. And they were also in sackcloth and ashes. Verse 14 says, but it shall be more tolerable. Y'all listen to that verse. It shall be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon at judgment than for you. Oh, Lord. And thou, Capernaum, which art exalted to heaven, shall be thrust down to hell. Oh, Lord. He that heareth, you heareth me. He that heareth you, heareth me. In other words, when you're a witness to somebody and you're talking to somebody about the Lord, if they hear you, they hear it him. Because it is him. But you got to be real and you got to be saved and you got to be what you're supposed to be in order to tell somebody else about this holy Jesus. God bless you. Because he is holy. He is holy. He is a good God and he's a God that loves everybody so much. So when he coming back as bride, but see, Satan ain't going to have more people than God. But God ain't going to make you be saved either. God is not going to make you come to him. That's up to you. Look at your neighbor and tell him it's up to you.
It's up to you.
Thank you, Lord. It's not up to me. It is definitely up to you. If you won't, see, I don't understand that I out there, you that are walking in sin and living in sin, I don't understand why you get to be as old as you are and you still in sin. What have sin gotten you up to now? What in the world have it helped you to do or help you to get? What have the devil helped you with? Thank you, Jesus. I know I got some folks' attention and some folks I don't. But you know what? It's okay. I'm just going to go right on and do what I need to do. And it's up to you because you know what? I'm not going to stand at the judgment with you. I'm not going to be there. And your blood is not going to be required in my hand because I'm going to tell you what thus said the Lord. And you know what? If you don't hear, that's on you. Y'all hear me now? I said if you don't hear, that's on you. For Tyre and Sidon, degree of punishment. Not the structure of punishment, but the degree of punishment. Don't misunderstand. Now, no one is saved but through our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. If you got saved any other way, hey, you better come back and get on your face and call on him. And if you came any other way to God besides through Jesus Christ, you ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing. So in order to be saved, you got to come to me. Because Jesus is the only one that can save you. Are you listening to me? I said Jesus is the only one that can save you. Nobody else can do like him. Can't nobody save you to the utmost. Can't nobody save you. They can pull you out of a pool. that you going down for the third time, they can save you from that.
Yeah.
But they cannot save your soul.
Yeah.
They cannot save your soul. Only Jesus can save you from an accident. Only Jesus.
Yeah.
Nobody else can. Think about what you're hearing. Can't nobody do it like Jesus can. The judgment of God is according to complete impartiality. When a problem is this daily practice, when you have a problem, this daily practice, hallelujah, glory to God. I'm not going to have this acting up in here. Little girl, sit in there. I'm not going to have it. I don't ever want to have to stop what I'm doing to discipline anybody. Hallelujah. Sit next to her, tap her on the hand, and let her know, I am not going to be distracted by you. Thank you, Jesus. Right now, I am having enough problems getting this word out in order to be trying to discipline somebody right now. All right? God is good.
Yes, he is.
James, the second chapter, 1-6. Hallelujah. Is God good? Let me say it again. Is God good?
Yes.
Hallelujah. And you're in his house to listen to his word. You're not going to learn when you allow the devil to block your thoughts in your mind. And
no.
The devil just block what you, he don't want you to hear.
That's right.
He don't want you to hear nothing from God. I don't care how young he is, you got mine.
Yes.
I don't care how young you is, you know right from wrong. Now, y'all know I don't mind doing what I need to do.
Amen.
When I need to do it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. James, the second chapter, 1-6. Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Because James talked about, saying James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. And he talking to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad. My brothers, tell you to do something. Count it all joy. Talking about the joy. Devil ain't gonna take her joy away. Devil ain't gonna take my joy away. But my brothers, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptation.
Yeah.
Know this,
yeah,
that the trying of your faith worketh,
yeah,
patience.
Yeah. Yeah.
But let patience have a perfect work,
yeah. Yeah.
That ye may be perfect and entire.
Yeah.
Wanting nothing. Verse 5. And I like this. If any of you like wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberty, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given. Now, him, in verse 6, but let him ask, how are you going to ask? In faith. Nothing wavering.
Yes.
For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. Anybody see themselves in the scripture?
Yeah.
You got to see yourself in the word, because if you don't see yourself in the scriptures, you won't get it right.
Yeah.
See, when you see yourself,
right,
then you'll do something about it. But God is here. God is right here,
yeah,
right now,
yeah,
to make everything right. Give it to him.
Yeah.
Cast your cares on him.
Yeah.
Whatever going on in your life, give it to God, because he's the only person that can fix it.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit came back to me, to God, to comfort. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is here. Why is he here? How do you know he's here? He's in me. Huh? Glory to God. Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
God is a mighty good God. I said he's a mighty good God. We need to learn how to hear. I can hear with my eyes too, you know. I can see, hear, and see my eyes see, hear things that ain't been spoken out. Praise God. So, I wonder why Bishop looking at me. My eyes hear something that I don't like, and I know if I don't like it, God don't like it.
All right.
The problem here is the church. Mm-hmm. If you know the right person, listen to this. You got a lot of folks in the church I can get ahead because they know the right person. They compromise. They know who's gonna compromise. They know who's gonna put some sugar on it. They know. You got to know the right person. They say you got to know the right person in order to get ahead. In these corporate places, you got to know somebody. All the church needs to know is Jesus.
All right.
All right.
You don't need to know the pastor to get close to the pastor so you can get favor. No. Praise God, hallelujah, y'all hear me? You don't need to know nobody but Jesus. He is your source. He is your wisdom. He is the one that is going to cause you to get ahead. Only one that can cause you to get ahead. Quit depending on humans. Learn how to lean and depend upon the Lord. I know you hear me. That said, if you hold the right title, I'm a bishop. So what? What that got to do with Jesus? So what am I? If I'm a bishop, I'm a pastor, I'm a prophet. You don't know who I am because I heard somebody say that one day. I don't know. You don't know who I am. I sure don't. Because you sure ain't a child of the King.
All right,
now, if you was a child of God, I would know who you are.
Right.
Titles don't mean nothing, y'all.
Yeah.
Man, these things is in the Bible. Bishop is a desired office. These things are in the Bible. We don't run away with the fivefold ministry. Apostles, prophet, evangelists. Come on here, somebody. Preachers / teachers. Come on, somebody. You ought to be able to do these things without getting a big head about who you are or who man say that you are. God is the one that say who you are. And if you're not trusting God, being faithful to God, and you're doing what God told you to do, then you're nobody. Glory to God. I said glory to God. Judgment day is coming. Thank folks that forgot that you got to die one of these days.
Yeah.
Glory to God, you ain't going to live forever.
Yeah.
You ain't going to even live old as Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob did.
Right.
You ain't going to live old as Methuselah. Come on, somebody. God only gave you 70.
Yeah.
My God. He's an awesome God, y'all. We're talking about the judgment of God because God is going to do his thing. He is. He is. He's going to do what he know he's supposed to do. Now, if you hold the right title, it said, I'm a this and I'm a that. Okay, you're nothing. You better get Jesus so you can be, I'm a Christ-like child. According to all the facts. Glory. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
Isn't he wonderful?
Yes.
I am about to get ready to wind this up. God shall judge the secret of man. Can we say that again?
Yeah.
All these secrets that you got down inside of you and you think they hid, y'all better hear me. God is going to do that. You need to hear me, hear what I'm saying now. God's going to judge. I didn't say man was going to. God is going to judge all your secrets that you think don't nobody know. Ah, hallelujah, Jesus. God is good, he is. Because he said man's heart is wicked. It is. Man's heart is wicked. Crime at night. Some of them wait till the nighttime to do their little stuff. And you got some that don't care about God, man, nobody else will do it in the daytime. Walk in bold as you are. Do any mess in the daytime. Hallelujah, Jesus. Crime at night, secret thoughts, and intent, covetousness, with your eyes roaming, looking at somebody that don't belong to you. Your eyes are roaming, you're lusting in your heart. Good God. God is good. He is good, my sister. He knows every secret thought. I said, God knows every secret thought. What's doing in secret will come to the light. It's coming. If I was you, I would do like me. I'd make sure I ain't no secret thing there because I won't repent. God, anything that's down there that I don't know about, get it out. I might have did something I didn't know I did. Come on, God, but you know you're supposed to know everything you do. But praise God I probably had a nasty dream. Oh, that got to get out of my house. That kind of spirit can't stay in. That kind of spirit can't stay in my house. You got to go. You got to go. You got to go. He knows them little things. God knows them little secrets. God knows all spirits. God knows them bad spirits. God knows them masturbation spirits. God knows how. Come on, somebody. You know what you're doing. God's looking at you out there. God see you out there. He knows everything. Oh, anybody here? I say God knows everything. Jesus. I'll be scared. And not to live for it. I would really be scared. Because you know what? If he come and I ain't right, I'm going to hell. Y'all hear me? I'm scared to. I got to be obedient to God because I'm too scared of him. I reverence him too much. I ain't scared that he gonna hit me with a bat or whatever. I reverence him. Oh, he's awesome. He's awesome. He's awesome. I ain't been right all the time. I need to say that. Sometimes the songs that I've been wrong in my life. Have you been right all the time?
No.
That's why folks come up and say, I knew you when. What am I? Do you know me now? Since you knew me when, what do you know about me now? Oh, look at me now. The same person when is not that person now. I used to dance back. I stayed on the dance floor. And you know what? And even when I came to God, I danced for him too. Until sometimes I fall out. I still move slow. But I move. And it's all for him and it's not for the devil.
Amen.
Now, as I get ready to close, I have two more scriptures for you. How to accept the final judgment of God. John 5:24. This is St. John 5 and 24. Ah, he already know. You know, my baby sister that died, she had that same boy.
Yeah.
Well, she whooped that on you in a minute. I already know and didn't know nothing. I already know. Eloise, what do you know? You don't know how to be saved. You, if you did, you'll get saved. Praise God. Amen. That's a sister. I ain't sugarcoat the word for her. And she would leave my house and go to Elvis' house, but Elvis still didn't sugarcoat the word. Good. She got tired of me, and then it cussed me out and get on out of there. Get up and go on over there on First Street. Praise God. And still died in her sin. I don't feel sorry because she was told. I'm not going to sit up here and get feeling sorry for folks that die in their sin because they could do better. They could do better. You got a chance.
Amen.
You have a chance. Right now. Ah. Well, what did we say? 5 and 24. God is a spirit. And they that worship him. Now see what we said. How to accept the final judgment of God. You got to accept it because God is. Somebody just say he is. A spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Hallelujah.
That's how you get away from the final judgment. That kind of judgment, because you won't be judged for not worshiping God. You won't be judged for not knowing him because you know him. Oh, that I may know him.
Yeah.
Paul said in the power of his resurrection. Yeah. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We got to know him. You know of him, but you don't know him. You got to know him.
Amen.
You cannot follow what you don't know.
Amen.
Ah, isn't he wonderful?
Yeah.
As one more scripture for you, 8 and 1. There is therefore Romans 8 and 1. There is therefore. Now, I want y'all to know. I'm going to read this and read it slow. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I thank the Lord for his word. I thank God out there with you. If I were you, I would repent right now. I would ask God to come into my life. I would ask God to be my Savior. I would ask God to live in me. Help me through the Word to study and know that you're real, God. I don't know if you're real, but what I am hearing from the message is that you are a real God. I ask you on today to save me to the uttermost. Save my life. I realize and know that I'm doomed without you. Thank you right now. Thank you for saving me, Lord. And if you out there have prayed that prayer with me, then you are just the same. And then we want you to go and find you a Bible church that teaches the unadulterated word of God.
Yes.
Get there and sit and listen. I didn't say go and join no church. I said sit and listen. Get the word in you. Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
For your word. Thank you for my listening audience.
Yes.
Thank you right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Access Vision, your voice, your community.